In the JavaScript ecosystem, we have a tool to address almost every kind of problem. But there's still areas so unexplored or difficult to tackle that they're practically in our blind spot. Sometimes we don't even realize that they're missing until someone actually comes up with a way to do it. Today, I want to introduce you to a new kind of tool, a resource for any framework or library, and one that I think will soon become a common element of our JavaScript landscape. Hi, I'm Tomek and I work at StackBits. As an engineer, but also just a web enthusiast, I'm always excited to see all the innovation around the capabilities of the tools we build, on their speed and on the overall developer experience. But as an educator, I know that we also recognize the need to innovate on how we communicate about these tools. So let's talk about documentation. What specifically am I talking about when saying documentation? Some of you may have already heard about the four quadrants of documentation. These are reference, explanation, how-to guides, and something else that I'll come back to in a second, but you may already have some idea. Today, with frameworks like Starlight, DocuSource, or VidPress, we have a great foundation for the documentation content. The content is generally a static text plus code snippets, although you can also add some interactive elements with live demos using StackBits SDK or embeds. But if you want to focus on the learning aspect of the documentation, we'll need to go a step further. We'll want a curated experience that combines a user guide with a battery of logically organized demos, or even better, exercises. After all, the best way of learning is by doing. So let's talk about tutorials. 5 years ago, Rich Harris pioneered an in-browser interactive tutorial experience to help developers get to know Svelte. It was a set of challenges with explanations running in a coding environment, all structured into an ultimate onboarding resource for the framework. When SvelteKit came along, its tutorial needed a backend layer, which was technically way more challenging. But in the meantime, StackBits came up with web containers that allow to run backend in the browser. So the Svelte team started working with us to create Web Containers API, specifically so that frontend and backend tools can be run in an in-browser tutorial. And these days you can see it in action with the official SvelteKit, Angular, and soon Next tutorial. And their communities love them. There's just one big problem. Behind this elegant and efficient form factor hides a lot of complexity. Building a tutorial app like this can be prohibitively difficult. Imagine just how much you'd have to code to get to a simple hello world screen in the setup like this. On the other hand, all these tutorials have a very similar structure and functionality. Almost like storybook projects that all have the same look and feel, because no matter if they use React or Vue components, they're all presented using the same storybook framework. So we have something that is very useful and repeatable, but also has to be built from scratch. Kind of insane. And that's why, based on the experiences of our friends from SvelteKit, Angular, and Next teams, we've built an open source tool that any team can now use to create interactive tutorials. We call it TutorialKit. Okay. I could tell you more, but just let's see it in action. So we start with the most straightforward command ever by running npm create tutorial. This generates the whole project and the initial content. Here, I've written the proverbial hello world in well under a minute. So what can this tutorial do? We can see the lesson description and the code and the live preview and even the interactive terminal. If we're stuck on our exercise, we can click to see the solution. And we can navigate through all the topics in the tutorial using the outline in the drop-down menu. The app is available in a dark and light theme, and it supports custom theming as well, so you can align it with your project. All this is configurable. If a student wants to continue playing with a specific exercise, they can open it as a StackBits project. By the way, this also makes it a great starting point for all the DevRels and dev advocates out there who want to have a library of demos at hand for live coding and such. So that's the user-facing part. Now, how do we create these lessons? For the description section, I just create and edit markdown files. These are actually MDX, so there's a lot of flexibility as to what you can put there. I can create reusable components or use some of the built-in ones, like code snippets or this info aside. And the code that runs in the interactive environment is placed in the files and solution folders for the given lesson. When I edit the description or the code, all updates live, as you might expect. At this point, the most common question we get is what type of code bases can run in this interactive environment. And in short, this can be any JavaScript code that can run on web containers. In other words, if it's possible to run it on stackblitz.com, it will also work in TutorialKit. Web containers are actually the secret sauce here. They allow the projects you run in a lesson to utilize any package manager you like, to run monorepos, and even work behind a company VPN or use private packages. Speaking of technical details, under the hood, every TutorialKit project is in fact a static Astro site. So it's really fast and you can deploy it pretty much anywhere. To make working on tutorials as convenient as possible, we've also created a companion VS Code extension. So let's look at what it does. I can easily navigate the tutorial outline without having to traverse the whole project codebase. I can also create new lessons. Just click and all the necessary files are generated. The extension also provides IntelliSense used for the lesson configuration because there are tons of options here. You can use them to customize the lesson appearance and functionality. So this is TutorialKit. We've only launched it recently and people who are already building on top of it seem to be as excited as we are. Also, it's an open source project, so it constantly evolves and we always welcome new contributors. So now, when we have a dedicated tool that deals with this area, I think that interactive tutorials will become a common part of our JavaScript landscape, complementing the great documentation sites that we already have. If you want to learn more, head over to tutorialkit.dev and don't forget to share with us what you've built.